may hear some expletives in this video. Perhaps I should just explain that. The weffing bee is fisherman's vernacular for, goodness gracious me, snagged again. That's the 15th time today, and I must have lost four legs.
There's a big salmon leaping up this weir, the sea trout. One there. Didn't make it. F in this and F in that.
Oh, that's a little rough. Yeah, I think they're rough. Look at them.
Not very big yet.
No.
Loads of salmon and sea trout leaping up here. It's 20 to 3 on Friday, and we've just got about, I think, 2.5 feet in. But obviously, with the water being very low for a long, long time, they've all been waiting downstream for this fresh water, and now they're absolutely piling up seam and have been all week. I haven't seen anything massive, but there's been some nice doubles, but most of them, I think, are a bit smaller, maybe six pounds. It's fascinating just sitting here watching these fish. You know, they've come all the way from Greenland, these fish, in the Atlantic, obviously born upstream here, and making their way back up to where they were born. And it's a hell of a long way from the sea, is this. You know, they're coming up the Humber past Hull, up the Ouse. They'll be going up the Wharf and the Ewer. And here we are on the Swale. And yet it's not renowned as a salmon river, but there are obviously lots and lots and lots of them upstream of here. just sort of zoom in, this is where the, on that side where that bush is where the Archimedes screw is proposed. So it'd be quite interesting to know, well, what effect this Archimedes screw would have on this big salmon run. I mean, they've been piling up all week. I mean, there must, thousands and thousands of fish must have gone up here since this fresh water started coming down. Unfortunately, when I came down the other day, I didn't have the camera with me.
Get up there when it's running, you see? Oh, gotcha.
it gets sticky and hard and stuff. Well, look at that. Double shot. Right into it. Surrender. Look at that. I don't know whether it's coming off this one. Not the hook. You'll have to try and blow one up now, but it happens to happen, don't break it, yeah, we've got so much there. So that's it. Well.
We've had no barbel, we've had an eel, and we've lost about 10 weights these blocks sitting next to me. It's a real snaggy place, is this, especially the flood. Ooh, that was a nice fish. There again. And of course, when they get upstream and spawn after that, most of them die off. Which is all a bit sad.
And dip the rod top.
What's getting that big tool on?
Anyway, I'm not bothered with it, I guess. Well, I've got a rod out, I'm fishing, that's all that matters. That's what I'm watching. Right? That's what I'm
watching. I want to get to an air, but I'll leave. I want to go on
any lake down there.
Fabulous to watch, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's amazing.
Whoa, see that?
Come all the way from Hull without feeding them, it's amazing.
Anybody think you were left-handed?
That's a big fish going up that back corner.
Is it out on it?
Well, there's the weir. All the salmon leaping up it, salmon and sea trout. As you come down, there's the island, and here's a great mass of debris which has come down. Which I suppose if you want to get onto the Isle of Lady, you'll have to clamber over the top of it. That'd be a right news. That's what it's all about, just sitting on the riverbank, enjoying it. It's wonderfully warm today. And all that rubbish just downstream there, a good place for holding bar, but you can see where the form just swings round past it. Wonderful, wonderful way to spend a day.